Let's start with the new one. So the manufacture of the fat line in the kiln burning, this is also the part of the last slide in which the hydraulic lime has a clay content is ranging from 10 to 30%. And for the manufacturing of this type of lime, the process depends upon the type of the raw material available. So hydraulic lime, we all know that there will be the clay content, the ranging about 10 to 30% will be there when we will manufacture this type of the lime. In which we have the two kind of lime again, like the natural hydraulic lime. So how you will get this one? So this is manufactured from a single raw material and impure limestone rich in clay known as the kankar and occur in the nature either in the form of blocks or making the lower part of the grout at many places. So in kankar contains, we have the 10 to 40% clay and 60 to 80% is the calcium carbonate will be there. And the calcination of the kankar is done in the clamp or in kiln in similar manner of the fat lime. As we get the fat lime from the kiln burning, the same like that, that you will get here the lime from the kankar in after the burning in the clamp and the kiln. So in case of the kankar, temperature is raised to the higher degree because of the presence of the enough clay in it and then cooled and then packed it. So we will burn up to the higher degree. So in this form that you will get here, then we have the artificial hydraulic lime. So artificial hydraulic lime, this type of lime, the two source materials are required, the limestone, rock and clay. Limestone should be free from the impurities and the clay should not contain any free silica, oxide of iron and the sulfur alkalis, etc. And there are the two variations of the calcination for the manufacturing of hydraulic lime depending on the quality of the limestone. So the calcination depends upon the quality of the limestone. Okay, limestone is the soft type, example the chalk. So such a stone is mixed with the clay in powder form and burned to red hot in any type of the kiln, and then burnt mixture is slacked on cooling before the marketing. So on the other, we have the limestone is the hard type, like we have the compact limestone and calcined in the kiln to obtain the quick lime and then cooled and powdered and mixed with clay to 10 to 30%. By weight and mixture is converted into the ball shaped masses. So these two calcination that you will do in the case of the artificial hydraulic lime. So these balls are once again charged into the kiln and then burned into the red heat. So it is known as the twice kilned. It is known as a twice kilned lime. So in this picture, like you will add the water and slate line that you will get here. Then we have the properties of the lime. The following are the more important properties that determine the quantity of lime as a building material. The physical state of the lime as obtained from the kiln is generally in the shape of a solid lump and is termed as a lump lime. Okay, so lime is crushed to obtain the powder of the required fineness known as a pulverized lime. When we convert into the finest form, then that will be known as the pulverized lime. Then we have the properties of the most important, that one is the slaking. We all know about that. And what is basically the slaking of the lime or the hydration, the process of the chemical combination of the lime with a definite quantity of the water so that the end product is the hydrated oxide. So when the lime cannot absorb any more water with the process is said to be completed. Okay, the new product calcium hydroxide is formed as per the following reaction there. So the above reaction is attended by the following processes. The first one is that is the evolution we have. So heat is generated of the order of 227 K calories per kg of lime. So the heat that will be generated first, then the expansion will be there. So the volume extent up to the 2 to 3 times, so that there must be the expansion also. And the development, the hissing and the cracking sound due to the conversion of the water into heat. So like same like that when we do the whitewash at our homes, and when we add the water in the in that lime, in the quick lime, and that kind of the sound that you will listen there, like the hissing and the cracking will be there. So the fat lime hydrated in 3 to 4 hours, and the hydraulic lime hydrated in 1 to 3 days. So all limes must be slaked before using building construction. So like this, we do the slaking of the lime, slaking of the fat lime or the quick lime or the rich lime. So one of the same thing we have, and when we add the water there, so you will get the hydraulic lime by the process of slaking. Then the methods of slaking, we have the different methods like the tank slaking, the making a lime putty. So the two big tanks of the suitable dimensions are constructed adjoining to each other and with a difference in level. The first tank is about 45 centimeter deep and made at a height. Second tank is 60 to 75 centimeter deep and made at a lower level. So two tanks we have to place with the different level, the one that will be the upper level with the height of 45 centimeter, and the other that will be the 60 to 75 centimeter depth. This is the second on the lower level we have. So the water is filled in the upper tank to 3 to 4 of its depth, and fat lime is gradually added it in the small amounts. So water is constantly stirred during the addition of the lime. The slaking reaction takes place in this tank, which can be absorbed by evolution of heat and hissing and cracking sound. So 3 to 4 are for the complete hydration. The lime on reaction with excess water forms the milk of lime. It's a greening tap called the strainer with opening 0.25 mm is open, and hydrated lime allowed to pass into the lower tank. So it is allowed to stay in the second day for 2 to 3 second tank for 2 to 3 days. So this is the second tank here for 2 to 3 days, where it matures itself to the desired consistency. So this is ready as a lime putty, and it is taken out for use of the making mortars and plasters here. So this is known as a tank slaking.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
So that means lime after slaking is now ready for construction purpose.
Yes.
Okay, sir.
So this is the tank that I was talking about. Here you can see the two tanks here on the A and the B tank we have in a different level, and 0.25 mm strainer for the removal of the from passing the slaked lime into the first tank to the other tank. And here you can see above how. So here directly we adding the water on the tap water, and adding on the other side we are adding the lime there. That is the quick lime we have. Okay, the lime putty and the press putty through the sieves. We are passing the sieves and the mesh side between 1 and 2 mm there, and then the water must always come from the limestone and turn into the putty. Yes, Sandeep, you were asking something.
Yes, sir. I was saying that after slaking, it is in paste mode, and in that paste form, we are going to use in construction. Am I right?
Yes. Absolutely. Only the lime should be added to the water. So the methods of the slaking, the precautions that we need to take during the slaking, and only the lime should be added to water, and not water to lime and keep water stirring and hoeing for the some times or for more even after the boiling and hissing sounds are over in the tank. Then the lime putty should be taken out as soon as it becomes mature in the tank, and it should not be allowed to stiffen and harden before use. The same like that as we use the cement. So we know that that will take the strength, that will be changed into the hardened stage after the some time after the setting there. So before that setting, we need to use that material so that you will get the enough strength and you can mold into the different shapes and you can place anywhere, wherever you want to place it. Then the method.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, like yes. Cement can be take lime as in powder form and then put water on it and construct.
Sorry?
So like cement we use in powder form and on site we put water on it for the construction. Can't we do that with lime also?
Lime, the method is totally same. Here you can see in the case of the lime, what we are doing here, we are adding the water here and we are taking the time for the mature. So, but the mature lime that you will get when you will get your, you know, that the consistency paste that you will get. Okay. That should not be proper hardened. We have to use that before the hardening. The same like that on the other side, the cement, as we know that the initial setting time is 30 minutes. Okay, the ordinary Portland cement. And the initial setting, before know that, after that, the and the final setting, we have the 10 hours. Okay, so before, up to the initial setting, we have to use that cement mortar. Okay, same like that, on the other side, on the lime, after adding the water, before the hardening, we have to use. But the lime that should not get in the powder form there. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And the platform slaking for the powdered slaked lime, the watertight platform of the masonry or the cement concrete. Okay, on which platform where you have to make the slaked lime? So the watertight that should be the basically made by the masonry or the cement concrete, the PCC. Then the fat lime is spread in the form of a thin layer of about 15 centimeter height. So here you can see in this picture, we have like the platform first we made there and then we after the watering and sprinkling process we have to do. The small quantity of water is sprayed above that. And during the water sprinkling process, the lime heap is turned over and over again using spades. And when apparent slaking is complete, on the no further water is added, so the heap is covered with a board so that any further heat liberated on the slaking is used by the lime for its complete disintegration. Okay, so it is left for the 24 hours during which the time slaking may be completed. The lime is turned into the powder form of hydraulic hydrated lime, which is screened through 0.25 mesh sieve and ready for the use of making the mortar and the plaster. Okay, so that powder form that basically used for the mortars and the plaster, like we use for the use as a cement. We have the lumps that should not be made there. Lumps you have seen the neighbor legend. Then we have the slaking of the hydraulic lime. It is done by the following three methods. First one is the platform slaking, the slaking under pressure, and the slaking by hydrators. The basic difference in the slaking of the fat lime and hydraulic lime is in the fact that the latter is generally slow slaking and require less water as compared to the fat lime. Okay, the fat lime required the more water as compared to the hydraulic lime. Then the plasticity, the property of the lime we have, it is defined as the ability of the lime to spread evenly during the application. It is observed that, so in which the lime contains some magnesium oxide, the more plastic spreads smoothly and easily in comparison to the lime rich in calcium oxide. So as compared to the calcium oxide, the lime with some magnesium oxide, that will be much more plastic, and it will be smoothly spread that you want to spread it, and easily in comparison to limes and rich in calcium oxide. So lime rich in the calcium oxide, that is pure fat lime, hard to work, sticky and stiff quickly. The sand carrying capacity, when the lime is used in mortar or plaster, sand has to be mixed with it due to the following reason: to control the shrinkage of the lime on setting and to prepare a properly plastic mix of the desired strength. So this is the most important point that you need to know. When you will add the sand in the plaster, so that will control the shrinkage of the lime after the setting. And properly plastic mix will be made, and that you will get your desired strength. So the lime mix with the definite quantity of the sand is known as the sand carrying capacity of the lime. And the calcium limes are said to have the good sand carrying capacity than the magnesium lime, because that will give you the more strength as compared to the magnesium lime. So this is the plasticity, like this, the mortar that we can use for the brickwork, for the plastic work here. The properties of the lime, like the setting in which the setting of the fat lime in the free state or in the mortar is essential, a chemical process which involves following reaction. So during the in the setting, this kind of the reaction will be there. First, the dehydration, like the loss of water from the hydrated lime by evaporation. Then the carbonation, the combining of atmospheric carbon dioxide into the lime, the forming once again the additional material. When that will be react with the carbon dioxide, again the calcium carbonate that you will get there. So the net result of the setting is that it is again converted into the hardened substance, calcium carbonate. This carbonate act as a binding material when used as a mortar. So at this kind you will get the hardened lime, which we basically use for the mortar. Then the, again the setting property, the setting of the hydraulic lime is a complex process. This is due to the fact that the hydraulic lime contains besides oxides of calcium and magnesium, silicates and aluminates of calcium, and some oxides of iron. So during their setting, these compounds get further hydrated and form crystalline structure. So it is for this reason hydraulic lime can set underwater also. It is more like Portland cement than fat lime. So this is just like the Portland cement that you will show you the proper setting, and then so that's why the reason behind the hydraulic lime can set under the water as well. The hydrated fat lime sets slowly compared to the pure fat lime. So the rate of the setting of the hydrating hydrated lime can be increased by the drying air and charging it with CO2. So shrinking take place in the lime on setting, which can be overcome by the mixing sand or surki. As I told you in the previous slide, the help of sand and surki, we can control that the shrinkage of the lime of, in the setting process. Then we have the handling and the storage of lime there. So the lime in its raw form requires the careful handling to avoid the accident and losses. So the how to handle and storage that lime, that we will learn from this slide. So in which the quick lime should be protected from the water as it will start the getting hardening. So with the evolution, the heat that can cause burn injuries of the various serious nature. So if it is stored in the wooden barrels and it comes in contact with the water, so much heat may be evolved to burn barrel. Okay, so house or the wagon trucks in which it is being transported. So fat lime must be protected from the direct contact with the atmospheric moisture and carbon dioxide, which start setting and get converted to a useless hard material having no binding properties. So it is therefore required to convert the lime into the lime putty as soon as possible and stored into the compact heat covered with a thick layer of lime. dust which saves the attack of the moisture. So this is how to protect the quick and the fat lime from against the atmospheric agencies, so that you can easily handle that material. Then the hydraulic lime, how to protect that? So safer in transport, it can be stored for the longer period as compared to the fat lime. So like here we have, this is the storing silos here. We have in which the various process to you will get your lime from these silos. This is the basically the steel silos we have, and the rotary kiln on the, like the filter receivers here we have, then the vacuum exhausters here, then the lime unloading rail car from here, and rotary airlock will be there. Then we have the pressure blowers from this side, and then the filter. Then it will get into the lime silos, and the vent filter will be there for the basically for the releasing of the air there. So this is basically is known as a truck fill line. So through that, the filling the silos there. So that you can see in the manufacturing, where there will be the manufacturing of the lime industries. So these kind of the silos that will be used there. Then the precautions to handle lime, the workers handling lime must be asked to use the goggles, respirators, rubber gloves and gum boots for the protection of the eyes, respiratory systems, hands and feet respectively. So the bath should be taken after working with lime. Any inflammable material should never be kept near a heap or bag of lime or where the lime is being hydrated to avoid any accidental fires. So these kind of the precautions that we need to take when we are using the lime, and always take to ask to the labor on site. These kind of the precautions. Then we have the uses of lime there. So lime is a very useful material that finds extensive applications in building construction, industrial and agriculture. So as a construction material, lime was used to make the building material in all types of the construction till 19th century. So even now, the lime can compete with the Portland cement in many types of the constructions, as a mortar mixed with sand and sulfur, as a plaster, as a whitewash, which gives the sparkling white finish at very low cost, as a lime concrete similar to the cement concrete made by the mixing lime, sand and quartz aggregate in proper proportions. So lime concrete that you can also make as a, like we make the cement concrete by adding the sand and quartz aggregate there. Quartz aggregate means the bajri. And the sand lime bricks, which are quite popular in many countries. So nowadays the lime not obsolete properly, but we are using also for some important constructions here. So this kind you can see the have the various uses of the lime. The woodwork we are using as well here on the walls, for the plaster work as well we are using. So here you can see these pictures here. The first, the calcium carbonate we have, then the glass that you will get here heat with sand and sodium carbonate. The glass that you will get utilize the acidic soil and take. So for the agriculture purposes as well as we are using these properties of the calcium carbonate, then the building and roads on the other side, mortars by adding the cement, water and sand here, and the concrete as well, the cement, sand, gravel and water. The construction limestone here, we have the lump limestone, powder limestone and cement. So steel making, agriculture, glass making, as I told you, the water and slag lime, agriculture, mortar, chemical purifying water, So for all these purposes, we are using this lye. As an industrial material, it is in industries, the lime find used as efflux in the metallurgical industry as a refractory material for the lining metallurgical furnaces, as a raw material for the manufacture of the glass. An agriculture input, the lime is used to improve the productive qualities of the soil and added to the poor soils to enrich their lime content. Lime has also been used for the soil stabilization. Okay, soil stabilization when means the when we need to improve the properties of the soil. Okay, and we can also replace with the lime with some percentage. We can also use some percentage of lime for the stabilization of the soil as well. Okay. Here in this picture that you can see for the or limestone.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
So what is exactly soil stabilization mean?
Soil stabilization means basically stabilization, when we stabilize, like we change, we want to change the properties of that material. Okay. Then we mix with the other material in which you will get the same properties will be there. Okay.
So not clear, sir.
Not clear?
Yes, sir.
Stabilization means like we know that our soil, okay, in which the soil properties like the bearing capacity of the soil we have, okay, and which is basically known as the load carrying capacity. So if you want to improve that properties, okay, then you can add some other materials with the there.
As an admixture?
Sorry?
As an admixture,
like we are adding the lime there.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that is known, is basically is known as a stabilization.
Like in concrete structures, we do grouting so that the strength can be increased in the same manner.
No. Grouting is the other process. Grouting is just we are filling that area with the cement mortar, with the cement mortar paste. Okay, grouting is not grouting. You can say that is the other term which we use in the construction. Grouting and stabilization is totally different.
Isn't it like the pores of the soil content are being filled by these lines?
Stabilized means when we want to change some properties of the material by adding the other material with it. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So, like, if we are adding the lime in the soil, so there must be the properties of the soil that will be changed here.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes. Sir.
When on the one side, like, if you want to test this one, on the one side we are simply testing the natural soil we have. Okay. And on the other side, when we are adding some content of lime in the soil, and then we check that properties of the soil. So there must be difference in between the properties of the natural soil as well as with the stabilized soil we have. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So that means the soil stabilization here. So here we have the soda lime glass that for this purpose that you can use, as I told you in the previous slide. Then for the agriculture purposes that we can use. Okay, so here you can see the kiln figure we have. So where we made the lime as well. So this is a comparative study of the fat lime and the hydraulic lime we have. So the properties like the fat lime and the hydraulic lime, the color, white color, this is a grayish white composition, the CaO with the subordinate amount of clay, the CaO with the 10 to 30% of the clay in the hydraulic lime. Slaking quality is slaked vigorously, slaked gently. Enough heat is liberated that creates hissing and cracking sound. Not much heat is liberated, so no hissing sound is there. Expand 2 to 3 times. Slaking time 3 to 4 hours. Expand 1 to 2 times. Slaking time 24 to 48 hours. Setting. The setting involves absorption of the carbon dioxide from atmosphere, resulting in the calcium carbonate. It cannot set under water as it does not have a property of hydraulicity. But on the other side, how the double setting action CaO content may set as a fat lime and clay form hydrated aluminates and silicate of the calcium to cement on the setting. And it can be interset under water as it has property of the hydraulicity. Strength, not very strong in mortar, so may not be used where the high strength binders are required. So quite strong mortar, so can be used in the foundation and wall in the place of the Portland cement. Uses the whitewashing, plastering, making a mortar. Used as a flux in industry and for soil improvement, and used for making the mortar in the load-bearing construction for underground and overground superstructure. So this is enough strong hydraulic lime as compared to the fat lime. So this is an important question. The comparison study, the difference in between the fat lime and hydraulic lime, that you can to call these terms.
We can say that the fat lime is generally for the appearance purpose, not for load bearing.
Yes, not only for the appearance purpose, as well as if we are using for the whitewashing and for the plastering as well. Okay, so there must be some strength also.
Yes, sir, but comparatively low.
But very low as compared to the hydraulic lime. Then we have the test for the limes. So the building lime required to satisfy a number of tests before it is approved for use in construction work, in which first one we have the chemical composition. So the lime is tested to determine the ratio of the different components such as CaO, MgO, SiO2, AlO2 and iron oxide. So the limit of components should be as per this code IS 712-1973, which we are basically used for the chemical composition of the lime. So in which you will get.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Can you show us on internet that IS 712-1973, what is written over there?
Okay. So after the completion of this PPT, I will show you that.
Okay, sir.
Then we have the fineness test as well to determine the fineness of the grain size by the sieve analysis. The residue is weighed after the test and should not exceed the specified limit. The same like that, the cement, in which when we go for the fineness test, the residue that should not be more than the 10% of the weight retained. Then we have the soundness test. It is the capacity of the lime to resist the soundness that will be related to the expansion on the setting. So it is tested with the help of the leach atelier apparatus. So this leach atelier apparatus that we also use for the soundness test of the cement as well. Okay. So the lime is mixed with the sand and water and filled in the mold of the apparatus. The distance between the indicator point is noted, and after 1 hour, the placed in a steam boiler for the 3 hours. And after the boiling action, the distance between the indicator is noted once again. The difference between the two readings gives the measures of the soundness, which should be in the prescribed limit. So in the case of the cement, that should not be more than the 10 level. So this is the same apparatus, leach atelier apparatus, which we are also used to check the soundness of the cement. So this is the apparatus we have. This is called the leach atelier apparatus. So this is the two indicators we have. Okay. And the distance in between. So these are the mould. So this is the two glass plate which we have to place at the bottom, and one we have to place on the upper side when you will fill this mould with the lime. Okay. Then after, and this is the weight that you have to put after placing the glass plate, after filling the mould with the lime. Then when you will place the glass plate, then you have to put the weight above that. And then you have to put into the water bathtub for the boiling temperature for the 3 hours. Okay. And then the distance between the indicators. First we noted that the indicator point, what is the distance in between that, and after 1 hour place in the steam boiler for the 3 hours. After the boiling action, again we need to calculate the distance and the difference between the first reading and the second reading. That difference, that will be the soundness, that will basically fix the soundness of the line. Then the setting time, we have the lime that lapses between preparing of lime paste of standard consistency and the setting of the same paste after it has been filled the standard mold, the wicket mold, to a minimum specified depth. And the initial setting, so the time that lapses from the gauzing to the penetration of the wicket needle in the paste up to a specified depth 35 mm. So this is the wicket apparatus, wicket mold, that we also use to check the initial and final setting time of the cement as well, that I will show you. And the final setting time, the time that elapses from the gazing to a time when the wicket needle cannot more penetrate in the paste and make only a mark on the surface. So we use a needle there. So for the initial setting time, that needle that will be penetrate up to the 35 mm depth. Okay, but in the case of the final setting time, when that will get the proper strength and that will get the proper hardened there. So when it will be hardened, so the needle that will not penetrate in that paste, and that needle when that will touch the upper surface of that material, that will show you just the mark the above surface. Okay, so this is the setting time test we have. This one is the wicket apparatus we have, that we also generally we use for the setting time of the cement. So this is the mold we have. First we have to fill this mold with the lime. Okay, this one, and this is the wicket apparatus, and here we need to apply the needle, and then we have to release that, and this needle that will be penetrate in this mold. So if when on which time up to that time where the needle is penetrating up to the depth of 35 mm, that will be the time of the initial setting. Okay, and on the other side, when the needle will not penetrate and just show the impression above the top surface, like this one is the hardened mold we have, this is the hardened material we have, and when we will put the needle above that, that will not penetrate it. So that will just show the impression above that surface. Okay, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Then we have the strength test there. So the tested by preparing the specimen of the standard sand lime mortar for the compressive strength, the average of 12 specimen test on standard testing machine on specimen taking after 14 days and 28 days. And for the transverse strength, average of 6 specimen, the test on the standard transverse strength testing machine. The setting time and strength test are recommended by the hydraulic lime only, because that will give you the enough strength. So same like that, as we test the concrete with the help of mound on the compression testing machine. So same like that, we need to fill the sample. Okay, we need to fill that mold and the
sitting. Hello, sir.
Yes,
that sitting time and strength tests are recommended only for hydraulic lime, sir.
Only for hydraulic lime,
not for fat lime. Why
not for fat lime? Because these two tests that we basically use for the hardened material, in which you will get the better strength.
Sir, maybe that it is for load bearing purpose. That's why.
Yes, because that will be much harder as compared to the fat lime.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that's why we will go for the setting time and strength test for this hydraulic lime.
That means, sir, for fat lime we are not more concerned about their strength.
There is no need to check that fat lime, because we are only using for the whitewash purposing. So why we will go for the test for the strength as well as for the setting? Okay, when okay, we sir. Are used for the building construction, we need to we have to make the brick wall there. Okay, now they require some strength there. Okay, like the load bearing walls we have as well, and we on the other side we are using the lime concrete, like the lime concrete in which we are adding the sand as well as the aggregate there. Okay, so that will be just like a stone. But now you need to know that what will be the strength that will give you. Okay, after these days, after the 14 days and 28 days. Okay, getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Because the sampling of this hardened, of that material which we are going to use, that is very important. Because the first, when you will cast any element of the structure, like we are casting the beam, column and slab of the building. Okay, so on that time we will use here the fresh concrete. We don't know that because we cannot use the hardened concrete there. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
We always use the fresh concrete because when it will be hardened, so we cannot use that material. So that's why we will take the sample on that time when we are using that concrete, that fresh concrete. So that will be hardened after the 14 days. Then you can check the strength, the material which we are used for this component, is it okay or not? Is it safe or not? Okay, getting my point?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is the main reason behind that, to take the sample of this material. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.